am Dr. Maushini Garis. I am Associate Professor at Government Medical College, Nagpur. And today I will be demonstrating non-rotational occipital forceps. So, and this I will be talking about the forceps. First of all, I will tell you the indications of forceps application. And I will show you the parts of the forceps. Then what are the prerequisites to apply the forceps. Then actual application of forceps. So, I will be describing forceps underneath. So let us know what is forceps application. Forceps is an instrumental delivery to aid the mother to deliver her baby. RCOG recommends that forceps should be applied by a very competent and skilled obstetrician. And it also recommends that when all the armamentarium for cesarean delivery is available, then only forceps application. So first of all, we'll start with the indications of forceps application. First and the commonest indication is maternal, for maternal exhaustion, when prolonged second state of labor, fetal indications like acute fetal distress, or fetal bradycardia, or suspected, or known abnormalities in the CTG. Then there are also some certain indications where we have to cut short the second state of labor, like in maternal cardiac diseases, then previous cesarean sections, severe preeclampsia, or other maternal medical illnesses. So these are the commonest indications where we apply forceps. So now I will be telling you about the parts of the forceps. These are the common type forceps which are routinely used. These outlet forceps. These outlet forceps consist of four parts: blades, the shanks, the lock, and the handle. The fetal head fits firmly into the bill. Now let us know what are the curves of the forceps. Snugly fits into the fetal head. The shanks provide the length to the forceps, and these are the handle for the gripping of the forceps. This release forceps consists of English locks. There are various other types of locks also, like sliding lock and French locks. Now let us know what are the curves of the forceps. Many people have confusion regarding this, so let us know what is the cephalic curve and what is the pelvic curve. Cephalic curve in the forceps is this, in which the fetal head snugly fits. Then the second is the pelvic curve, which lies along the birth canal. So these are the various parts of the forceps. Now the most important thing to know is what are the prerequisites for the applications of forceps. But without fulfilling these prerequisites, we are not supposed to apply forceps. First and the foremost in prerequisites is the informed consent. The patient should be explained in a vernacular language what is going to be done, what is forceps application, what are the risks and benefits of forceps application. If there is no consent, forceps should not be applied. The adequacy of the pelvis. Pelvis, maternal pelvis should be adequate for forceps application for the delivery of the baby. There should be no amount of cephalopelvic disproportion. If there is slightest doubt regarding the adequacy of the pelvis, forceps applications should not be tried. Let us know what are the prerequisites for application of forceps. First of all, the cervix must be fully dilated. The membranes may be ruptured. The placentic part must be well below the ischial spines. The head must be engaged. The sutures must be in sagittal sutures must be in anteroposterior direction. The bladder must be empty. So these are the prerequisites which must be fulfilled. Now regarding anesthesia, you may give local anesthesia, or pudendal block may also be given, or if the patient is an epidural for the labor anesthesia, then top up may be given. Now there are two types of application, that is low forceps application and outlet forceps application. In modern obstetrics,